rolling, they hating, patrolling and trying to catch me riding dirty, 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 trying to catch me riding dirty. My music's so loud, I'm swinging, they hoping that they gon' catch me riding dirty, trying to catch me riding dirty, trying to catch me riding dirty.
This is our position time graph, and we were able to figure this out by calculating the position based off of a reference point in Logger Pro.
And using the position time graph, we were able to find the velocity by finding the slope of the line of best fit of our points, which was, in this case, 1.1 meters per second.
Try to jack for some, but we packing something, and what we have for we have it locked up in the maximum security cell. I'm gripping old music loud, and I'm tipping slow.
To double check our velocity based on the position time graph, we also calculated it doing this. We did displacement over change in time, and we did it based off of the first meter. So what we did, we put 1 over 0.9, which was our change in time, thus resulting in 1.11, which is just as close as our velocity based off of the slope of the position time graph. And right here, I have a our velocity time graph, and this little part right here was the short time when it was accelerating at the beginning, and then it eventually leveled off and was at a more continuous velocity.
Yeah, so we also found the acceleration by taking the final velocity minus the initial velocity all over a change of time, in which case our final velocity is 1.1 meters per second, as previously stated, minus the initial velocity, 0, all divided by change in time, 0.9, which yielded our acceleration being 1.23 meters per second squared. And this is our acceleration graph. As you can see, it accelerated for a little bit, like over there in the velocity time graph, but then it reached a constant velocity, so the acceleration did not change.
All right, we calculated momentum by multiplying m by v, and our mass was 0.107 kilograms multiplied by the velocity of 1.11. That equated to P, momentum, at 0.119 kilograms meters per second.
And also, we did the net force for the car during the first meter by multiplying the mass in kilograms, which is 0.107, times the acceleration, which was 1.23 meters per second squared. And when you multiply those two together, you get 0.132 newtons as your final force.
Our energy bar diagram is the initial energy with work added in resulting kinetic energy. And from that, we were able to derive this equation to figure out the amount of work as well as the amount of kinetic energy. Here you can see work equals half mv squared. In our case, it was 0.07 kilograms times 1.11. where this resulted in the amount of work, which was 0.066 joules. And that is also the amount of energy delivered.
Yeah, so taking the work, we can also find the power by dividing the work by the amount of time. So in this case, we have 0.066 joules divided by 0.9 seconds to get our final power of 0.073 watts.